Okay, all praises be to the Most High in the name of Yeshua. We're here on the Sabbath day. Again, Lord, watch that button over there. I know this technology, you are far away, and we'll be back together soon. But all praises be to the Most High. An interesting last couple of weeks, to say the least. So we're glad that piece is behind us so that we can continue in the work. But before I go into the class today, and the class today is going to be called Gentiles, okay? It's probably a good title in lieu of just debating a Gentile, and I know that's what's around the world right now. But it's interesting. I was, you know, this Sabbath I got up, you know, do my prayer, get up and was in thought and said, you know what, we need to just discuss a little bit about this. Not the Gentile side. We know what their plots and are against Israel. And it's not just against us, but against everyone, right? But I would like to thank the Most High for that, what we went through. Because through that, we had an interview through the Spirit of the Most High, an initial interview with an international broadcast that's going to exalt the truth so that we can exalt the Most High even further. One thing about this is people have to understand that when it comes to attacks and all those things, it really doesn't affect me like that. Why? Because I'm here to do the work, bring souls to the Most High for this kingdom. That's all that matters. And if it's through anything, even if it's through my fault, that the Most High get exalted, I'll take that too. Okay. But one thing that you do notice is the online thing, as far as what people tell me. Now everyone is coming out. I guess when you cut on the lights, everybody's, you know, everyone has an opinion. I guess that's what online is for. And it's deep because, you know, they're examining me. And it's almost and in a lot of ways it's shameful. In other ways it's comical. Who am I? Okay. So, but what we have to say to the brothers that are within our church that are baptized and the sisters that are within our church, we encourage you to stay strong, because the attack is not just against me, it's against you also. But you have to realize and look at the sources from whence some of these attacks are coming from. You have to look at the sources from where these attacks start. And I'm speaking of the circumcision, the Israelites. Okay. Why? Is it because of the doctrine? Yes. Is it because of the name of the Most High? Yes. So we've always been attacked by them. But how should you view their observation of us? Well, the question is, will you take a... one moment here. Would you take a biased... I would say an unbiased observation from an enemy? If someone is your enemy, can they give you the intel or the insight on their enemy? Now, some people might look at this and say, well, man, that's a little harsh. We're brothers. We're Israelites. How can you just out recall and say these people that are saying this are enemies? This is how. And then we're going into the lesson. I don't want to spend too much time on this because I guess that's what they're looking to do, get some recognition off of us. Let's go, Elder Lawyer, to Ecclesiasticus 12 and 7 in the Apocrypha. Obviously, what they haven't observed or made videos on is how many people came to the Most High through this church throughout the four corners of the earth. I think that should be what's exalted and celebrated amongst the work, amongst those who are called to be Israel. That brothers and sisters all over the earth are turning from sin, being baptized, following the commandments of the Most High, turning towards the kingdom, trying to be better people. Should not that be magnified? Not with an enemy. Read Ecclesiasticus in your Apocrypha. And let's start at 12 and 7.
Yes, sir. This is Ecclesiasticus, chapter 12, verse 7. Give unto the good and help not the sinner. A friend cannot be known in prosperity.
A friend cannot be known in prosperity. That means when everything is going good and you got something, you don't know who your enemies are, brothers and sisters, because you don't know what they're there for. So when everything is fine, that's not when you recognize your enemy. Read.
And an enemy cannot be hidden in adversity.
Read that again.
A friend cannot be known in prosperity.
A friend cannot be known in prosperity because you got people that's going to come around and get something. And what?
And an enemy cannot be hidden in adversity.
An enemy cannot be hidden in adversity. So when something is going wrong and they see, okay, oh, now we can jump on this. They're just revealing who they are. In every idle word spoken, we will give an account on the day of judgment. The angels are watching. And so you notice that's why I don't attack people and put out their names and all that and say, well, he said this and say that. Because that's the kiddy little thing that children would like to get into. Okay, they want that little thing for recognition. We are building a kingdom. Okay, that's what men do. Men don't deal with futile internet battles. It's kiddie. It's childish. It's not the work. Read it again, that last piece.
Ecclesiasticus chapter 12, verse 8.
There's a lot, and guess what? There's a lot in this. I'm trying to take my time with this so that brothers and sisters don't get caught up in the fray, in the diversion. While everyone is paying attention to that, a lot of things are going on that we really need to be paying attention to. It's over. James White is out of here. He was slammed. He's a philosopher. He's gone. Finished. Okay. But the Most High have allowed the work to move on the next level, on the next platform, because of what seemed like a slip up. So I praise him for all of this. I thank him because he's seen something that I didn't recognize. It was him the whole time. Okay? Read.
Ecclesiasticus chapter 12, verse 8. A friend cannot be known in prosperity, and an enemy cannot be hidden in adversity.
Come on.
Verse 9. In the prosperity of a man, enemies will be grieved.
Read it again.
In the prosperity of a man.
When a man is doing good and prosperous, when the Most High is blessing a man, a what?
Enemies will be grieved.
Enemies will be upset. So So when they see the church growing and people calling on the name of Ahiah and Yeshiah being baptized, and is not dealing with all of these Pharisees and Sadducees doctrine, and is not dealing with polygamy and all these other things, that grieves them. When they see the church doing well and spreading, they get upset. Read.
The rest of verse 9. But in his adversity, even a friend will depart.
In adversity, even a friend will depart. But there are some real friends that stay. See? See, adversity shows who's really together. Who you can really trust when things really go down. Now, if you think they'll throw the dirt on you now, what will happen when the mark of the beast is on the scene? Okay, but the Most High needed me to see this also. And I thank him for this. I really thank the Most High this Sabbath for the whole thing and seeing the reaction of my brother. I needed to know who I could trust. Okay, I needed to know that because I don't put out nothing negative on anyone because I don't know one day whether or not I'll need them. Okay, or I don't know what the Most High is doing with them at this time. Even if we're not together, the Most High could move it where we come on one accord. But if we put something out negative that we can't get back, we can't take back, those things are solidified. Unless someone says, you know what, I apologize. I'm sorry, I was wrong. I was caught up in the melee and the internet controversy. Read, and let me tell you, I don't care what they say out there. We're doing the work of the Most High. This is his work. Even if, you know, I fall and whatever the case might be, his work will be done. It was prophesied. I'm not Christ, I'm a servant. And as long as I get up and do the Most High's work, day after day after day, and bring forth more souls to him, he'll be satisfied with me. That's all that matters. That Christ is satisfied with me. Not no brothers that are looking to bury and destroy their own blood. Whom I'm fighting for too. Okay? Read it. What verse you left off at? Come on.
This is Ecclesiastes chapter 12, verse 10. Never trust thine enemy.
Read. That's why I said I'm glad I seen this. The Bible says never trust thine enemy. No sooner something go on, they want to show, oh yeah, I told you. He destroyed the whole doctrine. What doctrine? What doctrine was discussed? What are y'all talking about? We're going to go into the doctrine. What doctrine was discussed? No, you want the doctrine to be destroyed because it's exposing the evil doctrines that are in this earth attached to Israelites. The doctrine of Christ stands. We're going to go through them in a moment. This is why we have enemies. Why? Because Christ had enemies. The disciples had enemies of their own brethren. And you know what? I can take it. Okay, I can totally sleep at night without even thinking about it. Because if I'm doing the work and bringing souls to the Most High, and they're being baptized, and they're being and they're straightening up, we got schools for children. We have a lot of things going on all through the earth in the name of the Most High. Okay, so think about that. But an enemy that would make them that would infuriate them. Why not talk about that? Read that last part for me again, Elder Lawyer, if you mind. You don't mind. 10. Go ahead.
Never trust thine enemy. For like as iron rusteth,
as so iron rusteth,
So is his wickedness.
So is his wickedness. Okay? Iron will rust. It may take time, but eventually it rusts. It says, don't trust your enemy, because if they're an enemy amongst you, eventually they're going to show who they are. And I know, I've been around brethren who seem as if they're with you and all that, and in their heart, they hate your guts. They're not real. So what they do, they wait for an opportunity to take down. Now we got some brothers that I haven't seen or heard from almost a decade. 7-8 years probably, and seen them in passing. Don't even know these people. They haven't even seen the work that the Most High have done through this church. Trying to make an observation. Open your eyes. Now, this thing that happened didn't have nothing to do with this Gentile, now that I'm looking at it. It had everything to do. It had everything. It's really showing what's wrong with Israel. Everything the Most High do is about his people. Okay? Everything he do is about his people. So the Most High, I'm going to show you how great this is. And I'm going to hold your place if you don't mind, Elder Lawyer. I'm going to show you how great the Most High is here. He even showed deficiencies that I needed to look into. Being a student and a servant, I needed that and have no problem with it. We're putting together a whole historical team and everything. And on top of that, if that didn't happen, when I was interviewed the other day by the international broadcast, I could not have answered certain questions. I was able to answer those questions because of that discourse. Okay. I never professed to know everything, but I know the doctrine of Christ. You can't debate me on that. No one can debate the doctrine of Christ. But this is showing enemies amongst Israel. Vain talkers. Okay? Read it.
This is verse 11, Ecclesiasticus 12 and 11.
Come on.
Though he humble himself.
Though he humble himself, the enemy will always come as they humble. Yeah, brother. Yeah, you know, Christ is this and Christ is that. Yeah, brother. Uh-huh. See, you know, I really wanted to help the brother. I was telling him he was going the wrong way. Read it.
And go crouching. Yet take good heed and beware of them.
Beware of your enemies. Read.
And thou shalt be unto him as if thou hadst wiped a looking glass. Mm. And thou shalt know that his rust have not been altogether wiped away.
And you're going to see that he was just laying low for the opportunity to destroy. That really, it wasn't Christ. It wasn't the Most High. I hear the Israelites, everybody speaking, yeah, on the street, yeah, we need to come together. Yeah, we need to come together. We need to be brethren. Gather together, O nation not desire. Well, yeah. This is what you do. You become an enemy. You tear down from within. Aren't you undoing what you called to do? And some people say, no, we rebuking. You ain't rebuking nothing. Okay? You are a sinner, just like every other sinner on this earth. Rebuke you. Okay? Get in Christ. Focus on the work. And each day that you're doing the work, you're not sinning. From sun up to sun down. Do the work. From sundown to sunup, do the work. And you don't have no time for futile internet discourses. Trying to examine someone when you don't know what power is behind this work. You have no idea. It's Yeshaya, it's Christ, the Savior. It's the Most High, Ahaya. And I'm going to continue to exalt his name, even if it means more enemies. Okay? That's the name he gave Moses. That's the name we will exalt. So wait for my fall. The truth will only expand. It doesn't matter, because we have works all over the earth. The Most High called us to do it. You didn't do it. And if you are doing it, then good. Christ said, leave them alone. If this work is not of the Most High, it's going to come to nothing. That's what Christ commanded the disciples. When the disciples seen others that weren't a part of Christ's teachings at that time, casting out spirits. Christ was like, listen, if there was a problem with them, I would have stopped them. You do your work. Let them alone. And what they're doing is not right. The Most High is going to bring that to nothing. But you know, some of our brothers just need opportunity to grandstand. We got the truth. The Most High has the truth. Christ have the truth. And we're going to show you what that truth is today. And why they were always our enemies. Okay? It didn't start with what happened with this Gentile a few days ago. And I keep on saying Gentile, Gentile, Gentile on purpose. Why? Because he was one of the most pompous, disrespectful, evil men I've ever come across. I know Gentiles that are in the spirit of Christ that I would never denigrate or say anything negative towards. But this guy was a calculating, evil Jesuit looking to minimize the power of the book. So what I did purposely, I just stayed back and I'm like, you know what? At the end of the day, I'm just going to go through these scriptures and let everyone on either side examining me see that it's the Most High speaking through these scriptures and know that this guy is dealing with nothing but philosophy of men. He's in love with these men. He's given a credit to. And the only men that I was talking about was Isaiah, Jeremiah, Ezekiel, John the Revelator, Christ, Paul. You understand? Other lawyer, come on, more on the enemies. Read. Mm-hmm.
This is Ecclesiasticus chapter 12, verse 12. Set him not by thee.
Do what?
Set him not by thee.
Set him not by thee. So you can't come together with enemies, brethren. You cannot come together. How can you set an enemy by you and say, well, let's talk about building a kingdom? That's against scripture. So anyone that's talking about Israel coming together is delusional. Christ is going to gather Israel, the remnant that's in him. Okay? The Bible says you can't set an enemy next to you. How is it you believe in? The only thing you believe is that you both Israel. Well, that means Christ should have agreed with the Pharisees. He should have agreed with the scribes. No, it doesn't work that way. I can't sit here and talk with a brother on that level of building together. And he's called, we dealing with two separate gods. Now, I will respect him as a brother and honor him as a brother. and not do anything against him or whatnot. But no, I can't work with him. You understand? He can work with, two can't walk together lest they be agreed. So this, especially you young brothers out there and sisters, you got to get off of this thing that we all need to come together. When only 10% of us want to make it, and only one third out of that 10% is going to make it. Only a remnant will make it into this kingdom under Christ. We got to get off this kumbaya garbage. It doesn't work that way. We have greater enemies, believe it or not, amongst ourselves. At least we know who Edom is. We know who the other nations are. But the Most High is showing the enemies of Israel. Those that would want to kill or persecute or destroy or smear their own people. Hold up. In the name of the Most High. So the Bible says what? Read that again.
Set him not by thee.
Set him not by thee. So when we get certain information, even though we got elders all over the world and all that, and we talk about it, and even Gaja was saying a couple of weeks ago, even before all this happened, like, you know, we were saying that one day maybe we can all sit down and you know, once, because we're about to set it up all over the earth, a sea of white. Everyone is going to see. This work hasn't been in vain all over the earth. The Most High name is being called. And it's multiplying. So in time, we were going to sit down with certain people, but not those people. The Bible says you can't be sitting down with no enemy. Why? Read.
Lest when he hath overthrown thee.
Because that person will be looking to overthrow you. He's not sitting down to work with you. He's sitting down to circumvent a work that he wasn't a part of. Go on.
Lest when he hath overthrown thee, he stand up in thy place.
And that's the whole thing. They'll be like, yeah, let's come together. But really, they want to be over everything. What we do? We just did the work. We went out and we just did the work, and through total humility, not disrespected anyone, bringing forth the truth the Most High had given us, and the Most High spread the word. We disrespect no one. We treat people like we want to be treated. And we were just bringing these scriptures all over the earth, on the streets, by twos, you name it, in every venue. Look how big London has become in no time. We got brothers all over the earth and sisters all over the earth. Look what's going on in Australia. Okay, look at what's going on. And we bless you, brothers and sisters there. Look at what's going on in all in the Fiji Islands, in the Pacific, even in Asia. Look what's going on even in the East. Shalom Gedayawan. So, we're not going to have somebody sit next to us that's an enemy and say, well, this is the way things need to go. Christ is leading this. Okay? And we can't sit next to no one that don't believe in the doctrine Christ gave us. Okay? Cornelius had to sneak at night to learn the doctrine. He was an Israelite, high priest, but there was a higher understanding through the Spirit. The Pharisees and scribes and those who were just Israelites didn't understand. And it comes through humility. Humility, that's what it comes from. It can only come through being humbled. Okay? And the greatest humbling is to go before the water as a testimony before everyone around you, even those who you think are under you, and go under that water like Christ did and show that you are a sinner too. That's the greatest level of humility. That's the pathway into the Holy Spirit giving you greater understanding. And you will always walk in that humility, because that was the day you were born again and understood you were a sinner. Therefore, you're not in position to look to attack and destroy someone else when the Most High forgave you. Read.
Verse 12. Set him not by thee.
Set him not by thee. Read. But guess what? There are some brothers out there that are not a part of this church we can sit with. That came out too. Okay. We're not going backward. We're going forward. So if the Most High have us stumble, that's fine. What we do is look at it and say, you know what? Okay, let's sharpen it up. Thank you, Ahaya, for this. So I'm going to tell you, lawyer, when I had the interview the other day, right after that thing, a lot of the information that we researched to deal with it the second time was within the parameters of questioning for the international broadcast.
Right.
So to everyone else, it was one thing, but to the Most High, it was like, you know, they're going to ask you this, they're going to deal with that. You deal with this. Doesn't matter. You deal with whatever comes. I deal with the negative that comes from it. But the next platform that the Most High want to be exalted and to warn the people about the mark of the beast and what's going on, it's here. And it allowed us to do that and answer those questions and deal with things that, you know, the Most High, sometimes he'll knock you back and say, well, okay, this is what you have to do. And you think it's for one thing, or don't even understand what you're going through at the time. And then the Most High shows his light on the other side and say, listen, keep in mind, this is not checkers. It's chess. Not checkers. It's not just one move. The Most High is moving the pieces. Where you at, lawyer?
This is Ecclesiasticus 12 and 12. It says, set him not by thee.
Set him not by thee, read.
Lest when he hath overthrown thee, he stand up in thy place.
He'll overthrow you and stand in your place. And that's what people are doing. They probably won't get no recognition any other way than trying to stand on the head of their brothers. Okay? They're just showing where they want to be. And guess what? I don't feel we're anywhere. To tell you the truth, we're all over the earth, but that's not enough. We're not finished. See? Go on.
The rest of verse 12.
Come on.
Neither let him sit at thy right hand.
Neither let him sit at thy right hand. Read.
Lest he seek to take thy seat.
Lest he seek to take thy seat. So when people are attacking, what are they really telling you, brothers and sisters? Come under me. Come under me. Doctrine wasn't even discussed. They're like, yeah, he destroyed everything. Go eat him. Go Esau. Get him, Esau. This is not checkers. It's chess. Okay? He was slammed. He can go back under where the philosopher he crawled from up under. And it's deep because other Christian communities are reaching out to the church now. That was listening to him. So Elder Gabbar from New York. And our consuls were saying, man, we have to get into these churches. Let's not crash the churches. Let's not crash them. But we got to find a way in which we can just be in there and they'll want us in. Well, we just baptized and converted a whole church in Philadelphia. They had me on the broadcast the other day preparing the breach. So we got a whole church, that Christian church, that converted. We have many pastors and preachers in our academy. On top of that, after this happened, many ministers reached out and are inviting the Gathering of Christ Church in. So we're not coming in to curse them out and tell them y'all doing wrong and all that, because a lot of them realize that they've been bamboozled. It's just now they need to be able to save face in front of their congregation. They need to know that we are not a threat to their flock. That's their people. They're spiritually invested in those people. So what we'll do is we'll help them with the doctrine so that they can be a part of eldership, so that their flock stay intact with the true doctrine. See? That's how it should be. Mutual respect and honor amongst brethren. No threat of someone taking someone else, because all of us belong to the Most High. No man belongs to another man. And that's why if you see anyone in this church, lawyer or any of the elders, you notice they have their own personality. You notice that they're not trying to be a carbon copy of someone else. That's the spirit. Okay? So through all of this, and I'm glad the Most High put attention to this. I'm so glad, because now the focus is where it need to be. And I need everyone that was even looking negatively, the enemies, keep your eyes open and see where this goes. Keep your eyes open and watch. Watch the work. And while you're examining us, the Most High's people will come into the truth. So focus on me if you would like. Okay. Read that last part again, Elder Lawyer.
Yes, sir. It says here, neither let him sit at thy right hand.
Come on.
Lest he seek to take thy seat.
Lest he seek to take thy seat. Go on.
And thou at the last remember my words and be pricked therewith. Verse 13.
He says, and then he says, remember my words or you're going to be pricked therewith. So we're going forward. There's so many people that haven't even been converted yet. Okay. So we're going to just continue to go on, and we will never sit with someone who's shown themselves to be an enemy until they publicly apologizes. Period. Whoever it might be, take their junk down and apologize. Then we'll actually think about it, because we're actually working. Okay? Go on, Elder Lawyer.
Verse 13. Who will pity a charmer that is bitten with a serpent?
Who will pity a charmer who's bitten by a serpent? You see these charmers that be dealing with the snake? Who's going to pity that guy operating with a snake once the snake bites him? Who's going to say, man, I'm sorry that happened to you? No, you shouldn't have been messing around with the snake. Okay. So we're going to take this advice from the Most High. We don't care about what men say. You add nothing to me. None of you enemies add one cubit, not even one centimeter do you add to me. All right. Christ have called us to do this work. Mind your business. Okay. Examine us while we continue to work. And I know what they'll do. People will go to him and say, yeah, look at this video. See, he didn't, he did, you know, it looked like he didn't know anything. Look. Don't even realize you give them that video. They'll look at that and they'll see all the other videos come up and click on it and get baptized next week. I don't care about that. I care that their souls are saved. So go ahead. I've seen people try to undercut, and the same person will look at the videos and say, man. And I said it before. I was on an 18-hour flight with 2 hours of sleep. Okay? So, yeah, my equilibrium was off a little bit, but it was the Most High that happened. I'm glad that happened. And I caught a head cold on the flight. I'm glad it happened. Okay? I'm glad. Because the Most High revealed so much. I'm sitting there looking at the whole thing unfold. And I'm like, man, this is absolutely amazing. And I'm telling the brethren, listen, this is nothing to get bent out of shape about. This is good. The Most High is going to use this attention here to exalt his name and the truth throughout the earth. I'll take one for the team. Go ahead, other lawyer.
The rest of verse 13.
Come on.
Who will pity a charmer that is bitten with a serpent, or any such as come nigh wild beasts?
Now, I'm going to show you why we have enemies real quick. And then I'm going into the lesson. And after today, you'll never hear me speak about this again. Okay? After this Sabbath is done, I'll never mention none of this. Because we have work to do. Okay? Including our academy tomorrow. Okay? Teaching people all over the earth. At one time. Setting up churches all over the earth. At one time. In the spirit of Christ. Setting up refuge knowing that hell is about to break out. All over the earth. At one time. Have you examined that? Let me show you why we have enemies. Let's go to Hebrews real quick. And then I'm going to actually do a lesson on Gentiles. Let's go to Hebrews 6, 1 through 3. And this is going to be titled, Enemies Within Israel. Okay? Hebrews 6, 1 through 3.
Book of Hebrews, chapter 6, verse 1.
Come on.
Therefore, leaving the principles of the doctrine of Christ, let us go unto perfection, not laying again the foundation of repentance from dead works and of faith toward the Most High.
Come on.
Of the doctrine of baptism.
Hold up. The doctrine of baptism. These are the works we must lay now, not the dead works that were under Moses. You got a lot of these guys think they know truth, but not realizing the greatest truth is self-examination and dealing with the spirit of baptism to receive the gift of the Holy Spirit. And I'm going to tell you this, more people in the Christian church have that than Israelites. Okay? Thank you. At least they understand that principle. Learning the book and figuring out that we came in out of slave ships and all that. That's not deep anymore. The Most High promised he would give that information back to us, us being Israel. That's not deep information. There's a higher level of understanding. So we must lay again the principles, what? Of baptism. This is why I'm an enemy of these people. Because they say that baptism is reading the word. That's utterly ridiculous because Nicodemus read the word. Okay? But he had to be baptized. The Pharisees and scribes read the word. Read.
And of laying on of hands.
Laying on of hands.
And of resurrection of the dead.
And resurrection of the dead. Being able to teach the resurrection. You can't teach the resurrection if you're teaching people there is no hell. It's utterly ridiculous. Okay? So what's going on is because this ministry has exposed the negatives and the false doctrines within Israelites, they're looking for an opportunity to destroy when they see a point of weakness. You can destroy me. You can do whatever you want to do with me, but you can't do nothing against the doctrine. Okay? And I'll take it. I'll take anything. Listen, in order to do this work, you have to be used to people attacking you or humiliating you. That's part of it. I'll take that because I know my Lord took more. I know Yeshua, our Lord and Savior, whom a lot of people out there call Jesus, took more. It's nothing. Okay? Like Paul says, he wished that he was accursed from his brethren. He wished he was accursed from Christ for his brethren, his kinsmen, according to the flesh, who were Israelites. He wished he could have went through some of the humiliation. And Paul went through a lot of humiliation. Not like Christ. The circumcision was always looking for a reason to point to Paul as a deficiency and not the right guy to do something. They was always looking for a reason to say, yeah, look at him with this new stuff. That's the circumcision. The circumcision, and you're looking through the circumcision, you're blind. You can only receive the gift of the Holy Spirit to understand the overall work. And that's why I don't even, that's why personally, I don't talk about no Israelite groups and all that. Because I understand that they're just dealing with the circumcision. But that's needed. So I leave them alone. I came from the circumcision. Okay? That was our schoolmaster to bring us to Christ. So everyone need a schoolmaster. I would never say if somebody's in another group, yeah, join us. I don't care about that. Some people need to go through that. But believe me, that's only kindergarten. That's just the beginning. That's the schoolmaster. You have to receive the Holy Spirit to get information from on high to know what this is really about in preparation for Christ's coming. Read. Hold up, lawyer. You went out.
Let's lock it.
Go on.
And of eternal judgment.
And of eternal judgment. You have to know about the resurrection and eternal judgment. You cannot know about the eternal judgment if you don't know about the sons of God that came to this earth and brought forth evil from the beginning. Okay? We're not the only sons of God that will be judged. The original sons of God that fell to this earth will be judged and thrown in the fire after the 1,000 years of peace that Yeshua, or whom you call Jesus, or some people call Yehoshua, will bring. Some people call Yehoshua, will bring. So that's why we have enemies. We have enemies because some people will be out there talking about me with a big star Moloch up on them, where our children were sacrificed in the six-pointed star, which is not the star of our brother David, but the star of another David, okay? A recent David, Megan David, a Zionist, the Rothschilds, the red star, that's what Rothschild means, Edom's star because he's took it on. It was a star from way back when in paganism. So they'll get mad because we bring out that the Bible calls that star, the star Rimfan. We did, and not only that, we haven't talked about that in what? 6-7 years. So before you can examine us, look at yourself. Because why? I will never meet any man's expectations of what they expect from me. That's an impossibility. I don't know what you expect from me. I can only do the will of the Most High and what he has instilled in me. So you vain talkers, keep on talking. will be working. Hold up, lawyer. We're about to go into a lesson, the Gentiles. Thank you. One moment. Okay, all praises be to the Most High in the name of Yeshua. We're here on the Sabbath day. Again, lawyer, watch that button over there. I know this technology, you are far away, and we'll be back together soon. But all praises be to the Most High. An interesting last couple of weeks, to say the least. So we're glad that piece is behind us so that we can continue in the work. But before I go into the class today, and the class today is going to be called Gentiles, okay? It's a it's probably a good title in lieu of just debating a Gentile, and I know that's what's around the world right now. But it's interesting. I was, you know, this Sabbath I got up, you know, do my prayer, get up and was in thought and said, you know what, we need to just discuss a little bit about this. Not the Gentile side. We know what their plots and are against Israel. And it's not just against us, but against everyone, right? But I would like to thank the Most High for that, what we went through. Because through that, we had an interview through the Spirit of the Most High, an initial interview with an international broadcast that's going to exalt the truth so that we can exalt the Most High even further. One thing about this is people have to understand that when it comes to attacks and all those things, it really doesn't affect me like that. Why? Because I'm here to do the work. Bring souls to the Most High for this kingdom. That's all that matters. And if it's through anything, even if it's through my fault, that the Most High get exalted, I'll take that too. Okay. But one thing that you do notice is the online thing, as far as what people tell me. Now everyone is coming out. I guess when you cut on the lights, everybody's, you know, everyone has an opinion. I guess that's what online is for. And it's deep because, you know, they're examining me. And it's almost... in a lot of ways it's shameful. In other ways it's comical. Who am I? Okay, so, but what we have to say to the brothers that are within our church that are baptized and the sisters that are within our church, we encourage you to stay strong, because the attack is not just against me, it's against you also. But you have to realize and look at the sources from whence some of these attacks are coming from. You have to look at the sources from where these attacks start. And I'm speaking of the circumcision, the Israelites. Okay. Why? Is it because of the doctrine? Yes. Is it because of the name of the Most High? Yes. So we've always been attacked by them. But how should you view their observation of us? Well, the question is, will you take one moment here. Would you take a biased, I would say an unbiased observation from an enemy? If someone is your enemy, Can they give you the intel or the insight on their enemy? Now, some people might look at this and say, well, man, that's a little harsh. We're brothers. We're Israelites. How can you just out recall and say these people that are saying this are enemies? This is how. And then we're going into the lesson. I don't want to spend too much time on this because I guess that's what they're looking to do, get some recognition off of us. Let's go, Elder Lawyer, to Ecclesiasticus 12 and 7 in the Apocrypha. Obviously, what they haven't observed or made videos on is how many people came to the Most High through this church throughout the four corners of the earth. I think that should be what's exalted and celebrated amongst the work, amongst those who are called to be Israel. That brothers and sisters all over the earth are turning from sin, being baptized, following the commandments of the Most High, turning towards the kingdom, trying to be better people. Should not that be magnified? Not with an enemy. Read Ecclesiasticus in your Apocrypha. And let's start at 12 and 7.
Yes, sir. This is Ecclesiasticus, chapter 12, verse 7. Give unto the good and help not the sinner. A friend cannot be known in prosperity.
A friend cannot be known in prosperity. That means when everything is going good and you got something, you don't know who your enemies are, brothers and sisters, because you don't know what they're there for. So when everything is fine, that's not when you recognize your enemy. Read.
And an enemy cannot be hidden in adversity.
Read that again.
A friend cannot be known in prosperity.
A friend cannot be known in prosperity because you got people that's going to come around and get something. And what?
And an enemy cannot be hidden in adversity.
An enemy cannot be hidden in adversity. So when something is going wrong and they see, okay, oh, now we can jump on this. They're just revealing who they are. In every idle word spoken, we will give an account on the day of judgment. The angels are watching. And so you notice that's why I don't attack people and put out their names and all that and say, well, he said this and say that. Because that's the kiddy little thing that children would like to get into. Okay, they want that little thing for recognition. We are building a kingdom. Okay, that's what men do. Men don't deal with futile internet battles. It's kiddy. It's childish. It's not the work. Read it again, that last piece.
Ecclesiasticus chapter 12, verse 8.
There's a lot, and guess what? There's a lot in this. I'm trying to take my time with this so that brothers and sisters don't get caught up in the fray, in the diversion. While everyone is paying attention to that, a lot of things are going on that we really need to be paying attention to. It's over. James White is out of here. He was slammed. He's a philosopher. He's gone. Finished. Okay. But the Most High have allowed the work to move on the next level, on the next platform, because of what seemed like a slip up. So I praise him for all of this. I thank him because he's seen something that I didn't recognize. It was him the whole time. Okay? Read.
Ecclesiasticus chapter 12, verse 8. A friend cannot be known in prosperity, and an enemy cannot be hidden in adversity.
Come on.
Verse 9. In the prosperity of a man, enemies will be grieved.
Read it again.
In the prosperity of a man.
When a man is doing good and prosperous, when the Most High is blessing a man, a what?
Enemies will be grieved.
Enemies will be upset. So when they see the church growing and people calling on the name of Ahiah and Yeshaya being baptized, and it's not dealing with all of these Pharisees and Sadducees doctrine, and it's not dealing with polygamy and all these other things, that grieves them. When they see the church doing well and spreading, they get upset. Read.
The rest of verse 9. But in his adversity, even a friend will depart.
In adversity, even a friend will depart. But there are some real friends that stay. See, adversity shows who's really together. Who you can really trust when things really go down. Now, if you think they'll throw the dirt on you now, what will happen when the mark of the beast is on the scene? Okay, but the Most High needed me to see this also. And I thank him for this. I really thank the Most High this Sabbath for the whole thing and seeing the reaction of my brother. I needed to know who I could trust. Okay? I needed to know that. Because I don't put out nothing negative on anyone because I don't know one day whether or not I'll need them. Okay? Or I don't know what the Most High is doing with them at this time. Even if we're not together, the Most High could move it where we come on one accord. But if we put something out negative that we can't get back, we can't take back, those things are solidified. Unless someone says, you know what, I apologize, I'm sorry, I was wrong, I was caught up in the melee and the internet controversy. Read. And let me tell you, I don't care what they say out there. We're doing the work of the Most High. This is his work. Even if, you know, I fall and whatever the case might be, his work will be done. It was prophesied. I'm not Christ. I'm a servant. And as long as I get up and do the Most High's work, day after day after day, and bring forth more souls to him, he'll be satisfied with me. That's all that matters. That Christ is satisfied with me. Not no brothers that are looking to bury and destroy their own blood. Whom I'm fighting for too. Okay? Read it. What verse you left off at? Come on.
This is Ecclesiastes chapter 12, verse 10. Never trust thine enemy.
Read. That's why I said I'm glad I seen this. The Bible says never trust thine enemy. No sooner something go on, they want to show, oh, yeah, I told you. He destroyed the whole doctrine. What doctrine? What doctrine was discussed? What are y'all talking about? We're going to go into the doctrine. What doctrine was discussed? No, you want the doctrine to be destroyed because it's exposing the evil doctrines that are in this earth attached to Israelites. The doctrine of Christ stands. We're going to go through them in a moment. This is why we have enemies. Why? Because Christ had enemies. The disciples had enemies of their own brethren. And you know what? I can take it. Okay, I can totally sleep at night without even thinking about it. Because if I'm doing the work and bringing souls to the Most High, and they're being baptized, and they're being and they're straightening up, we got schools for children. We have a lot of things going on all through the earth in the name of the Most High. Okay. So think about that. But an enemy, that would make them, that would infuriate them. Why not talk about that? Read that last part for me again, Elder Lawyer, if you mind. If you don't mind. 10. Go ahead.
Never trust thine enemy. For like as iron rusteth.
As so iron rusteth.
So is his wickedness.
So is his wickedness. Okay. Iron will rust. It may take time, but eventually it rusts. It says, don't trust your enemy, because if they're an enemy amongst you, eventually they're going to show who they are. And I know, I've been around brethren who seem as if they're with you and all that, and in their heart, they hate your guts. They're not real. So what they do, they wait for an opportunity to take down. Now we got some brothers that I haven't seen or heard from almost a decade. 7-8 years probably, and seen them in passing. Don't even know these people. They haven't even seen the work that the Most High have done through this church. Trying to make an observation. Open your eyes. Now, this thing that happened didn't have nothing to do with this Gentile, now that I'm looking at it. It had everything to do, it had everything. It's really showing what's wrong with Israel. Everything the Most High do is about his people. Okay? Everything he do is about his people. So the Most High, I'm going to show you how great this is. And I'm going to hold your place if you don't mind, Elder Lawyer. I'm going to show you how great the Most High is here. He even showed deficiencies that I needed to look into. Being a student and a servant, I needed that and have no problem with it. We put together a whole historical team and everything. And on top of that, if that didn't happen, when I was interviewed the other day by the international broadcast, I could not have answered certain questions. I was able to answer those questions because of that discourse. Okay? I never professed to know everything, but I know the doctrine of Christ. You can't debate me on that. No one can debate the doctrine of Christ. But this is showing enemies amongst Israel. Vain talkers. Okay? Read it.
This is verse 11, Ecclesiasticus 12 and 11.
Come on.
Though he humble himself,
the enemy will always come as they humble. Yeah, brother. Yeah, you know, Christ is this and Christ is that. Yeah, brother. Uh-huh. See, you know, I really wanted to help the brother. I was telling him he was going the wrong way. Read it.
And go crouching. Yet take good heed and beware of them.
Beware of your enemies. Read.
And thou shalt be unto him as if thou hadst wiped a looking glass. Mm. And thou shalt know that his rust have not been altogether wiped away.
And you're going to see that he was just laying low for the opportunity to destroy. That really, it wasn't Christ. It wasn't the Most High. I hear the Israelites, everybody speaking, yeah, on the street, yeah, we need to come together. Yeah, we need to come together. We need to be brethren. Gather together, O nation not desire. Well, yeah. Yeah. This is what you do. You become an enemy. You tear down from within. Aren't you undoing what you called to do? And some people say, no, we rebuking. You ain't rebuking nothing. Okay? You are a sinner, just like every other sinner on this earth. Rebuke you. Okay? Get in Christ, focus on the work, and each day that you're doing the work, you're not sinning. From sun up to sundown, do the work. From sundown to sun up, do the work. And you don't have no time for futile internet discourses. Trying to examine someone when you don't know what power is behind this work. You have no idea. It's Yeshua. It's Christ, the Savior. It's the Most High, Ahaya. And I'm going to continue to exalt his name, even if it means more enemies. Okay? That's the name he gave Moses. That's the name we will exalt. So wait for my fall. The truth will only expand. It doesn't matter, because we have works all over the earth. The Most High called us to do it. You didn't do it. And if you are doing it, then good. Christ said, leave them alone. If this work is not of the Most High, it's going to come to nothing. That's what Christ commanded the disciples. When the disciples seen others that weren't a part of Christ's teachings at that time, casting out spirits. Christ was like, listen, if there was a problem with them, I would have stopped them. You do your work. Let them alone. And if what they're doing is not right, the Most High is going to bring that to nothing. But you know, some of our brothers just need opportunity to grandstand. We got the truth. The Most High has the truth. Christ have the truth. And we're going to show you what that truth is today. And why they were always our enemies. Okay? It didn't start with what happened with this Gentile a few days ago. And I keep on saying Gentile, Gentile, Gentile on purpose. Why? Because he was one of the most pompous, disrespectful, evil men I've ever come across. I know Gentiles that are in the spirit of Christ that I would never denigrate or say anything negative towards. But this guy was a calculating, evil Jesuit, looking to minimize the power of the book. So what I did purposely, I just stayed back and I'm like, you know what? At the end of the day, I'm just going to go through these scriptures and let everyone on either side examining me see that it's the Most High speaking through these scriptures and know that this guy is dealing with nothing but philosophy of men. He's in love with these men. He's given a credit to. And the only men that I was talking about was Isaiah, Jeremiah, Ezekiel, John the Revelator, Christ, Paul. You understand? Other lawyer, come on, more on the enemies. Read. Mm-hmm.
This is Ecclesiasticus chapter 12, verse 12. Set him not by thee.
Do what?
Set him not by thee.
Set him not by thee. So you can't come together with enemies, brethren. You cannot come together. How can you set an enemy by you and say, well, let's talk about building a kingdom? That's against scripture. So anyone that's talking about Israel coming together is delusional. Christ is going to gather Israel, the remnant that's in him. Okay? The Bible says you can't set an enemy next to you. How is it you believe in? The only thing you believe is that you both Israel. Well, that means Christ should have agreed with the Pharisees. He should have agreed with the scribes. No, it doesn't work that way. I can't sit here and talk with a brother on that level of building together. And he's called, we're dealing with two separate gods. Now, I will respect him as a brother and honor him as a brother and not do anything against him or whatnot. But no, I can't work with him. You understand? He can work with, two can't walk together lest they be agreed. So this, especially you young brothers out there and sisters, you got to get off of this thing that we all need to come together when only 10% of us want to make it. And only one third out of that 10% is going to make it. Only a remnant will make it into this kingdom under Christ. We got to get off this kumbaya garbage. It doesn't work that way. We have greater enemies, believe it or not, amongst ourselves. At least we know who Edom is. We know who the other nations are. But the Most High is showing the enemies of Israel. Those that would want to kill or persecute or destroy or snare their own people. Hold up. In the name of the Most High. So the Bible says what? Read that again.
Set him not by thee.
So when we get certain information, even though we got elders all over the world and all that, and we talk about it, and even Gaja was saying a couple of weeks ago, even before all this happened, like, you know, we were saying that one day maybe we can all sit down and you know, once, because we're about to set it up all over the earth, a sea of white. Everyone is going to see. This work hasn't been in vain all over the earth. The Most High name is being called and it's multiplying. So in time, we were going to sit down with certain people, but not those people. The Bible says you can't be sitting down with no enemy. Why? Read.
Lest when he hath overthrown thee.
Because that person will be looking to overthrow you. He's not sitting down to work with you. He's sitting down to circumvent a work that he wasn't a part of. Go on.
Lest when he hath overthrown thee, he stand up in thy place.
And that's the whole thing. They'll be like, yeah, let's come together. But really, they want to be over everything. What we do, we just did the work. We went out and we just did the work. And through total humility, not disrespecting anyone, bringing forth the truth the Most High had given us, and the Most High spread the word. We disrespect no one. We treat people like we want to be treated. And we were just bringing these scriptures all over the earth, on the streets, by twos, you name it. In every venue. Look how big London has become in no time. We got brothers all over the earth and sisters all over the earth. Look what's going on in Australia. Okay, look at what's going on. And we bless you brothers and sisters there. Look at what's going on in all in the Fiji Islands, in the Pacific, even in Asia. Look what's going on even in the East. Shalom Gedayawan. So, we're not going to have somebody sit next to us that's an enemy and say, well, this is the way things need to go. Christ is leading this. Okay? And we can't sit next to no one that don't believe in the doctrine Christ gave us. Okay? Cornelius had to sneak at night to learn the doctrine. He was an Israelite, high priest, but there was a higher understanding through the Spirit. The Pharisees and scribes and those who were just Israelites didn't understand. And it comes through humility. Humility, that's what it comes from. It can only come through being humbled. Okay? And the greatest humbling is to go before the water as a testimony before everyone around you, even those who you think are under you, and go under that water like Christ did and show that you are a sinner too. That's the greatest level of humility. That's the pathway into the Holy Spirit giving you greater understanding. And you will always walk in that humility, because that was the day you were born again and understood you were a sinner. Therefore, you're not in position to look to attack and destroy someone else when the Most High forgave you. Read.
Verse 12. Set him not by thee.
Set him not by thee. Read. But guess what? There are some brothers out there that are not a part of this church we can sit with. That came out too. Okay. We're not going backward. We're going forward. So if the Most High have us stumble, that's fine. What we do is look at it and say, you know what? Okay, let's sharpen it up. Thank you, Ahaya, for this. So I'm going to tell you, lawyer, when I had the interview the other day, right after that thing, a lot of the information that we researched to deal with it the second time was within the parameters of questioning for the international broadcast.
Right.
So to everyone else, it was one thing, but to the Most High, it was like, you know, they're going to ask you this, they're going to deal with that. You deal with this. Doesn't matter. You deal with whatever comes. I deal with the negative that comes from it. But the next platform that the Most High want to be exalted and to warn the people about the mark of the beast and what's going on, it's here. And it allowed us to do that and answer those questions and deal with things that, you know, the Most High, sometimes he'll knock you back and say, well, okay, this is what you have to do. And you think it's for one thing, or don't even understand what you're going through at the time. And then the Most High shows his light on the other side and say, listen, keep in mind, this is not checkers. It's chess. Not checkers. It's not just one move. The Most High is moving the pieces. Where you at, lawyer?
This is Ecclesiasticus 12 and 12. It says, set him not by thee.
Set him not by thee, read.
Lest when he hath overthrown thee, he stand up in thy place.
He'll overthrow you and stand in your place. And that's what people are doing. They probably won't get no recognition any other way than trying to stand on the head of their brothers. Okay? They're just showing where they want to be. And guess what? I don't feel we're anywhere, to tell you the truth. We're all over the earth, but that's not enough. We're not finished. See? Go on.
The rest of verse 12.
Come on.
Neither let him sit at thy right hand.
Neither let him sit at thy right hand. Read.
Lest he seek to take thy seat.
Lest he seek to take thy seat. So when people are attacking, what are they really telling you, brothers and sisters? Come under me. Come under me. Doctrine, let me tell you, doctrine wasn't even discussed. They're like, yeah, he destroyed everything. Go eat him. Go Esau. Get him, Esau. This is not checkers. It's chess. Okay? he was slammed. He can go back under where the philosopher he crawled from up under. And it's deep because other Christian communities are reaching out to the church now that was listening to him. So Elder Gabar from New York and our consuls were saying, man, we have to get into these churches. Let's not crash the churches. Let's not crash them. But we got to find a way in which we can just be in there and they'll want us in. Well, we just baptized and converted a whole church in Philadelphia. They had me on the broadcast the other day, preparing the breach. So we got a whole church, that Christian church, that converted. We have many pastors and preachers in our academy. On top of that, after this happened, many ministers reached out and are inviting the Gathering of Christ Church in. So we're not coming in to curse them out and tell them y'all doing wrong and all that, because a lot of them realize that they've been bamboozled. It's just now they need to be able to save face in front of their congregation. They need to know that we are not a threat to their flock. That's their people. They're spiritually invested in those people. So what we'll do is we'll help them with the doctrine so that they can be a part of eldership, so that their flock stay intact with the true doctrine. See, that's how it should be. Mutual respect and honor amongst brethren. No threat of someone taking someone else, because all of us belong to the Most High. No man belongs to another man. And that's why if you see anyone in this church, lawyer or any of the elders, you notice they have their own personality. You notice that they're not trying to be a carbon copy of someone else. That's the spirit. Okay? So through all of this, and I'm glad the Most High put attention to this. I'm so glad, because now the focus is where it needs to be. And I need everyone that was even looking negatively, the enemies, keep your eyes open and see where this goes. Keep your eyes open and watch. Watch the work. And while you're examining us, the Most High's people will come into the truth. So focus on me if you would like. Okay. Read that last part again, Elder Lawyer.
Yes, sir. It says here, neither let him sit at thy right hand.
Come on.
Lest he seek to take thy seat.
Lest he seek to take thy seat. Go on.
And thou at the last remember my words and be pricked therewith. Verse 13.
He says, and then he says, remember my words or you're going to be pricked therewith. So we're going forward. There's so many people that haven't even been converted yet. Okay. So we're going to just continue to go on, and we will never sit with someone who's shown themselves to be an enemy until they publicly apologizes. Period. Whoever it might be, take their junk down and apologize. Then we'll actually think about it, because we're actually working. Okay. Go on, Elder Lawyer.
Verse 13. Who will pity a charmer that is bitten with a serpent?
Who will pity a charmer who's bitten by a serpent? You see these charmers that be dealing with the snake? Who's going to pity that guy operating with a snake once the snake bites him? Who's going to say, man, I'm sorry that happened to you? No, you shouldn't have been messing around with the snake. Okay. So we're going to take this advice from the Most High. We don't care about what men say. You add nothing to me. None of you enemies. Add one One cubit, not even one centimeter do you add to me. All right? Christ have called us to do this work. Mind your business. Okay? Examine us while we continue the work. And I know what they'll do. People will go to him and say, yeah, look at his video. See, he did, you know, it looked like he didn't know anything. Look. Don't even realize you give them that video. They'll look at that and they'll see all the other videos come up and click on it and get baptized next week. I don't care about that. I care that their souls are saved. So go ahead. I done seen people try to undercut. And the same person will look at the videos and say, man. And I said it before. I was on an 18-hour flight with 2 hours of sleep. Okay? So, yeah, my equilibrium was off a little bit, but it was the Most High that happened. I'm glad that happened. And I caught a head cold on the flight. I'm glad it happened. Okay? I'm glad. Because the Most High revealed so much. I'm sitting there looking at the whole thing unfold. And I'm like, man, this is absolutely amazing. And I'm telling the brethren, listen, this is nothing to get bent out of shape about. This is good. The Most High is going to use this attention here to exalt his name and the truth throughout the earth. I'll take one for the team. Go ahead, Elder Lawyer.
The rest of verse 13.
Come on.
Who will pity a charmer that is bitten with a serpent, or any such as come nigh wild beasts?
Now, I'm going to show you why we have enemies real quick. And then I'm going into the lesson. And after today, you'll never hear me speak about this again. Okay? After this Sabbath is done, I'll never mention none of this. Because we have work to do. Okay? Including our academy tomorrow. Okay? Teaching people all over the earth at one time. Setting up churches all over the earth at one time in the spirit of Christ. Setting up refuge knowing that hell is about to break out all over the earth at one time. Have you examined that? Let me show you why we have enemies. Let's go to Hebrews real quick. And then I'm going to actually do a lesson on Gentiles. Let's go to Hebrews 6:1-3. And this is going to be titled, Enemies Within Israel. Okay? Hebrews 6:1-3.
The book of Hebrews, chapter 6, verse 1.
Come on.
Therefore, leaving the principles of the doctrine of Christ, let us go unto perfection, not laying again the foundation of repentance from dead works and of faith toward the Most High.
Come on.
Of the doctrine of baptism.
Hold up. The doctrine of baptism. These are the works we must lay now. Not the dead works that were under Moses. You got a lot of these guys think they know truth, but not realizing the greatest truth is self-examination and dealing with the spirit of baptism to receive the gift of the Holy Spirit. And I'm going to tell you this. More people in the Christian church have that than Israelites. Okay? Thank you. At least they understand that principle. Learning the book and figuring out that we came out of slave ships and all that. That's not deep anymore. The Most High promised he would give that information back to us being Israel. That's not deep information. There's a higher level of understanding. So we must lay again the principles, what? Of baptism. This is why I'm an enemy of these people. Because they say that baptism is reading the word. That's utterly ridiculous because Nicodemus read the word. Okay? But he had to be baptized. The Pharisees and scribes read the word. Read.
And of laying on of hands.
Laying on of hands.
And of resurrection of the dead.
And resurrection of the dead. Being able to teach the resurrection. You can't teach the resurrection if you're teaching people there is no hell. It's utterly ridiculous. Okay? So what's going on is because this ministry has exposed the negatives and the false doctrines within Israelites, they're looking for an opportunity to destroy when they see a point of weakness. You can destroy me. You can do whatever you want to do with me, but you can't do nothing against the doctrine. Okay? And I'll take it. I'll take anything. Listen, in order to do this work, you have to be used to people attacking you or humiliating you. That's part of it. I'll take that because I know my Lord took more. I know Yeshua, our Lord and Savior, whom a lot of people out there call Jesus, took more. It's nothing. Okay? Like Paul says, he wished that he was accursed from his brethren. He wished he was accursed from Christ for his brethren, his kinsmen, according to the flesh, who were Israelites. He wished he could have went through some of the humiliation. And Paul went through a lot of humiliation. Not like Christ. The circumcision was always looking for a reason to point to Paul as a deficiency and not the right guy to do something. They was always looking for a reason to say, yeah, look at him with this new stuff. That's the circumcision. The circumcision, and you're looking through the circumcision, you're blind. You can only receive the gift of the Holy Spirit to understand the overall work. And that's why I don't even, that's why personally, I don't talk about no Israelite groups and all that. Because I understand that they're just dealing with the circumcision, but that's needed. So I leave them alone. I came from the circumcision. Okay? That was our schoolmaster to bring us to Christ. So everyone needs a schoolmaster. I would never say if somebody's in another group, yeah, join us. I don't care about that. Some people need to go through that. But believe me, that's only kindergarten. That's just the beginning. That's the schoolmaster. You have to receive the Holy Spirit to get information from on high to know what this is really about in preparation for Christ's coming. Read. Hold up, lawyer. You went out.
That's locked.
Go on.
And of eternal judgment.
And of eternal judgment. You have to know about the resurrection and eternal judgment. You cannot know about the eternal judgment if you don't know about the sons of God that came to this earth and brought forth evil from the beginning. Okay? We're not the only sons of God that will be judged. The original sons of God that fell to this earth will be judged and thrown in the fire after the 1,000 years. Of peace that Yeshua or whom you call Jesus or some people call Yehoshua will bring. Some people call Yehoshua will bring. So that's why we have enemies. We have enemies because some people will be out there talking about me with a big star Moloch up on it, where our children were sacrificed in the six-pointed star, which is not the star of our brother David, but the star of another David, okay? A recent David, Megan David, a Zionist, the Rothschilds, the red star, that's what Rothschild means, Edom's star because he took it on. It was a star from way back when in paganism. So they'll get mad because we bring out that the Bible calls that star, the star Rimfan. We did, and not only that, we haven't talked about that in what? 6-7 years. So before you can examine us, look at yourself. Because why? I will never meet any man's expectations of what they expect from me. That's an impossibility. I don't know what you expect from me. I can only do the will of the Most High and what he has instilled in me. So you vain talkers, keep on talking. We'll be working. Hold up, lawyer. We're about to go into a lesson. The Gentiles. Thank you. One moment. Okay. What chapter and verse did you leave off, Elder Lawyer?
In Romans 11 and 14.
Come on.
If by any means I may provoke to emulation them which are of my flesh, it might save some of them. For if the casting away of them be the reconciling of the world, which shall the receiving of them be but life from the dead?
Be but life from the dead, which means if he can reconcile the world and teach and allow the whole world to have a part of an understanding within this covenant for the kingdom, how much more will it be when God's people begin to get it again? But life from the dead. It's going to be like life from the dead. Linking directly to Ezekiel 37, the valley of the dry bones. Or in Revelations, the 11th chapter, when we were reading just now, when it went into those dead bodies in Revelations 11 and 9. It's going to be like life from the dead. If he can reconcile the Gentiles, how much more his own people at the end? This is a doctrine that's not being taught in any Christian church anywhere. Go on.
Verse 16.
Come on.
For if the first fruit be holy, the lump is also holy. And if the root be holy, so are the branches.
The root was Abraham. The branches that came out of the root or the tree are the 12 tribes. So that means the Gentiles talking about they're in Christ and that they, you know, they're in God, in Christ. Well, hold up now. Don't forget that was someone else's tree before Gentiles were invited in. Okay. Go on, chapter and verse.
Romans 11 and 17. And if some of the branches be broken off, and thou being a wild olive tree were grafted in among them, and with them partakers of the root and fatness of the olive tree, boast not against the branches.
Hold up, read, hold up. Say that last part again. You cut out, lawyer.
Okay.
You cut out a little bit. Read that last verse once more, if you don't mind.
Yes, sir. I'll start at 17. And if some of the branches be broken off, and thou being a wild olive tree were grafted in among them, and with them partakers of the root and fat of the olive tree, boast not against the branches.
So Paul, magnifying his office, is telling all the Gentiles who are learning under the Israelites at this time, Paul being an Israelite, that they are not to boast against the natural branches. Why? Because they were grafted into the Israelites' tree. How can you now boast against the people who gave you an opportunity for the other side in a covenant that wasn't promised to you? So what is that boast, Elder Lawyer?
The rest of verse 18. But if thou boast, thou bearest not the root, but the root thee.
Because if you boasting, Gentiles, you're not boasting of your history. You're boasting about our history. And that's the reason we bring up color, and the disciples were all black people, and the Israelites were originally black. Not that we're racist or anything like that. We have to show you that you're boasting against the original people by staking claim to a tree that you were grafted into as a Gentile. Give respect to the original people, like Paul said. Okay? Go on. What is the boast?
Verse 19. Thou wilt say then, the branches were broken off, that I might be grafted in.
See, that's your boast now.
that the Israelites were done away with, so that us spiritual Gentiles now can now be the people of the kingdom. That the Israelites are done away with so that we can be the people. The doctrine within Christianity is that boast, that the same boast that Paul warned the Gentiles from. He says, if you want to learn under us, you cannot talk ill of these people and speak against them and say that the covenant and the blood of Christ that was sacrificed for them is for you. And that you're the people now. Read.
Verse 20.
Come on.
Well, because of unbelief, they were broken off. And thou standest by faith.
Thou standest by faith. Go on.
Be not high-minded, but fear.
Be not high-minded. Hold up.
The Most High.
Hold up. You broke off again. What verse are you in?
Verse 20.
Come on.
Well, because of unbelief, they were broken off. And thou standest by faith. Be not high-minded, but fear. For if the Most High spared not the natural branches, take heed lest he also spare not thee.
So if the Most High didn't spare his own people and put them in captivity and scattered them throughout the four corners of the earth during the times of the Gentiles, while they were getting rich off of us, if the Most High allowed you to rape, rob, and destroy us based on the sins of our fathers, look what he did allow you to do to us. What do you think going to happen to you? That's what Paul is saying. If the Most High can do this to his own people, what do you think he's going to do to you, Gentiles, if you begin to boast against his people? Huh? Read it, Elder Lawyer. What verse?
Verse 22.
Come on.
Behold, therefore, the goodness and severity of the Most High. On them which fell, severity.
He was severe with us. Come on.
But toward thee, goodness, if thou continue in his goodness.
So he will allow goodness on the Gentiles if they can continue in what Paul and Peter was teaching the Gentiles. Not this pagan stuff we see today. Or what?
Otherwise, thou also shall be cut off.
Period. First. So if you boast against the natural branches and teach a doctrine that God has done away with his people for you, the Most High is going to do worse to you, Gentiles. Read.
Verse 23. And they also, if they abide not still in unbelief, shall be grafted in. For the Most High is able to graft them in again.
Hold up now. If his people wake up at the end and find the truth and come under the covenant of Christ and the doctrine of Christ and be baptized in the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, they can come back and presume their original position according to Paul. And I know a lot of Gentiles out there, Gentile authority, they don't like that because that means they must yield their positions of authority for a changing of the guard. Go on.
Verse 23. And they also, if they abide not still in unbelief, shall be grafted in. For the Most High is able to graft them in again.
So if he's going to graft in his own people, how is room being made? Because the majority of Gentiles are in paganism anyway, boasting against the natural branches. So room has been made back for the 10 tribes that left in 721. So that Judah and Israel can be one together again like we were before the sins of Solomon. See? Go on.
Verse 24. For thou wert cut out of the olive tree, which is wild by nature, and were grafted contrary to nature into a good olive tree, how much more shall these, which be the natural branches, be grafted into their own olive tree?
So we're being grafted back into our olive tree, brothers and sisters. We're taking back our original place that was promised. Go on.
Verse 25. For I would not, brethren, that ye should be ignorant of this mystery, lest ye should be wise in your own conceits.
Go on.
That blindness in part is happened to Israel until the fullness of the Gentiles be come in.
Blindness in part has happened to Israel until the fullness of the Gentiles be brought in. Here's the mystery. That fullness of Gentiles, when you look at Genesis 48, it was told to Joseph by Jacob that Ephraim would be a multitude of nations. Ephraim was the king over the 10 tribes, which means that multitude of nations it's speaking of are the 10 tribes that left. That's why it says until the fullness of the Gentiles be come in, until the 10 tribes are back again. Read.
Verse 26. And so all Israel shall be saved.
That's why the scriptures say all Israel shall be saved, because during Paul's time, only Judah, Benjamin, and Levi were left. Now he's talking about all the tribes back together again. Go on.
And so all Israel shall be saved, as it is written, there shall come out of Zion the deliverer, and shall turn away ungodliness from Jacob. For this is my covenant unto them, when I shall take away their sin.
Well, he will take away Israel's sin. No longer would the Most High look upon the sins of our forefathers. Read.
Verse 28. As concerning the gospel, they are enemies for your sake.
As concerning the gospels, they are enemies for your sake. Now check that out. Go on.
But as touching the election, they are beloved for the Father's sake.
But as touching the election, speaking of Israel, they are beloved for the Father's sake. So that means, guess what? We're going to have much hatred with this gospel and doctrine. The doctrine of Christ is not a doctrine that people will easily receive. You have something to say on that, lawyer? You good?
No, sir.
Because we're winding down here. We want to make it clear that this doctrine is not a hate doctrine. It's setting the proper order of the church like it was before the Romans came in and destroyed us and began to taint the doctrine. And the Most High have set forth men in the last days to set the record straight in a preparation to receive a remnant within this earth at our time, among the Jews first and the Gentiles, in preparation for this kingdom. Where you at, lawyer?
This is verse 29.
Come on.
For the gifts and calling of the Most High are without repentance. For as ye in times past have not believed the Most High, yet have now obtained mercy through their unbelief.
Hold up. The Gentiles, who was in unbelief, received mercy through our unbelief. It was our forefathers that fell that allowed you to get anything. Go on.
Verse 30, 31. Even so have these also now not believed.
So our people who didn't believe, read.
That through your mercy, they also may obtain mercy.
Through your mercy, they also should obtain mercy. See that? So the Gentiles who didn't have it before received everything we had through faith. They held on to our records while we were in captivity. And when we begin to wake up through that mercy that was given to them, there was something available so that we can receive back the promises of sons. So if the Gentiles could receive it through mercy, so could the Israelites. Go on.
Verse 32. For the Most High have concluded them all in unbelief, that he might have mercy upon all. riches, both of the wisdom and knowledge of the Most High. How unsearchable are his judgments and his ways past finding out. For who have now known the mind of the Lord, or who have been his counselor? Or who have first given to him, and it shall be recompensed unto him again? For of whom and through him and to him are all things, to whom be glory forever. Amen.
Amen. So if the Most High showed mercy to the Gentiles, can he not show mercy to Israel? Let's go to Isaiah 14 and 1. And let's see what that mercy, the mercy that was prophesied to be fulfilled upon Christ's arrival.
Book of Isaiah chapter 14, verse 1.
Come on.
For the Lord will have mercy on Jacob and will yet choose Israel and set them in their own land.
So not the EU or the UN setting someone in the land. Christ will set us in our land. Read.
And the strangers shall be joined with them.
So these are the Gentiles that the Most High severed from amongst the Gentiles, a people for his name. Read, those are the strangers. Because the nation that will not serve Christ is going to die. Those that fight against Christ will die. Period. So these are they who understand the covenant and are preparing for the covenant. They're going to cleave to Jacob like the Gentiles are doing now through the gospel, through the teachings. Read.
And they shall cleave to the house of Jacob. Verse 2. And the people shall take them and bring them to their place, and the house of Israel shall possess them in the land of the Lord for servants and handmaids. And they shall take them captives whose captives they were, and they shall rule over their oppressors.
So according to the Bible, Israel, God's people, will rule over our oppressors. Now, when most think of this, they think about slavery and captivity and unrighteous law. When we're not going to treat people like that, okay? It's really going to be those that fight against Christ originally, during that first 7 years of takedown, that's going to suffer some serious pain before death. Okay? But in the kingdom, the other nations are going to love to serve. It's not going to be a problem to serve a righteous king. So that's the doctrine of the Gentiles. That right now we're living in a time of the Gentiles. Hey, it's your time. We can't fight against your time as much as you can fight against the time we got coming. We have coming. We're in a time of the Gentiles, but eventually there will be a changing of arms, because that valley of the dry bones are now awakened. And what do they fear of those dry bones? Let's go to Ezekiel 37 real quick. That when the Holy Spirit and the breath come upon them, The Gentiles are going to look upon these same people who you thought were made for nothing more than captivity or slavery. Okay. They're going to see what? Let's get it, Elder Lawyer.
Ezekiel 37, 9 through 10.
Read.
Then said he unto me, prophesy unto the wind, prophesy, son of man, and say to the wind, thus saith the Lord power, come from the four winds, O breath, and breathe upon these slain, that they may live. So I prophesied as he commanded me, and the breath came into them, and they lived and stood up upon their feet, an exceeding great army.
That's what they fear. That once we come to the knowledge of the truth, that those that are in Christ will be a part of that army. He will go up into the cloud according to the book of Thessalonians, and come back immortal with Christ. They fear that army. That's the army that will take down Satan's army. That in preparation, that's in preparation. That's the army that will take down Satan's army. That in preparation, that's in preparation right now to destroy us. They fear that. All right. So I wanted to go into that to show you that there is a difference in the doctrine of the Gentiles that's taught correctly without theologian influence. Okay. And it's not to take away from, you know, I want to say this. This is not, you know, the loving, the good feeling doctrine that you would normally receive in the churches concerning it. But it's the truth. All right. The Gentiles that operate in the spirit of Cornelius, that don't boast against the natural branches, you're going to be okay. You're going to be fine. There's going to be a serving period. You're going to be placed in the same land you were placed in when the earth was first divided. The earth will be cleansed for 7 years. The Gentiles are going to have to work to do that. And the walls will be built up. The Gentiles will work to do that. But once a year, they'll come up before our anointed Savior and receive from the tree of life that will keep them nourished throughout the whole 1,000-year span. And a totally righteous kingdom. See, and that's the proper doctrine concerning Gentiles. And the time of the Gentiles will soon be at an end. So next week, I'll make sure we go into the doctrine, well, the armies of this earth, leading up to the battle of Armageddon. Now that we're at the end of the time of the Gentiles now are circling the wagons, coming together for the final battle against what's coming out of the sky. They don't want to release or let go of their power and riches. So next week, we're going to go into the battle between the Gentiles and Christ, the battle of Armageddon, starting with the scriptures from the Valley of Jehoshaphat. Now, one thing I did leave out is Galatians 2, but I wanted y'all to go there yourself and you will see that the teachings primarily to the Gentiles were committed to Paul. And Peter primarily dealt with those who already knew they were Israelites. So there were two different ministries operating for the Most High's purpose. You'll only have the true doctrine of Christ when you understand and teach both. Okay. With that, we're going to answer a few questions and this, then we'll wish you all Godspeed. Hold for one moment. Lawyer, you have anything to say before we answer a few questions?
No, sir. No, sir.
Okay. Let me see there. Let me save this.